So our first piece was Shock Factor, and after that, we'll play a piece called Post Blue by a composer based in Brooklyn named Elliot Cole. And I really like his music because it showcases the exact opposite of what we hear of with lots of loud percussion. He does a lot of meditative work with, well, this summer I had the privilege to lead a piece in Tower Grove Park, actually, in St. Louis, called Flower Pot Music, where he makes music with different sized flower pots, and the tones and sounds that can come from that. And then another innovative thing he's done in this piece is he brings violin bows and cello bows and incorporates them as tools for percussion. So you're going to hear really gorgeous, luscious, lyrical sounds from the vibraphone in this movement of eight postludes. This is the eighth one. Stays in the same Zen mood that we just had from this meditative piece, Postlude, and that it is minimalistic music. So you'll hear a lot of beautiful chords that change over a longer period of time, repetitive motion that is finally changes and over the stretch of the piece. So, but within that, there's a groovy element too that I think you'll enjoy. So this is the first movement of Red by Mark Mellis. To some non-traditional instruments. You can see over there, soda cans. And this piece is titled Two Beginnings. The composer's name is Nico Schroeder. I met this gentleman actually this summer. He lives in Columbia, Missouri, so he's a local composer. And local to Missouri. And he writes a lot of really intriguing things, and I was just really taken aback by this particular piece because of the innovative approach to using recycled cans. And you'll see they're taped to brake drums from a car. So that kind of gives it a little bit of resonance, and then those will also come in handy at the end of the piece. You'll understand why when we get there. And the utensils we use are different from the mallets we would use on marimba that are wound with yarn. And they're different from our normal drumsticks. We're using dowel rods from a craft store. On one hand, we have a quarter-inch dowel rod, and the other hand, we have an eighth-inch dowel rod to bring out different sounds from the cans. So Nico, like I mentioned, he lives in Missouri now, but he's from Michigan originally. And the piece uses, you'll hear a lot of polyrhythms, so we'll hear different, like, triplets going on over 16th notes and over 8th notes all at the same time. That sometimes caused the piece to appear jumbled at times, and then we come back together, and then and so on and so forth. So It's cool that you'll hear one person with a melody, and then it passes off to another person and another person. These are his writing of using canons, so to speak. But his program note, I thought was interesting. I thought I would read it for you. The life cycle of an aluminum can is dominated by wildly divergent time spans. A brief and unceremonious formation and filling leads to weeks or months of waiting, which is followed by a very brief period of use. Cans stay in our hands for only a few minutes, but the relationship to us defines neither their beginning nor, as I learned to moving to a state with no bottle deposit, their end. We hope you enjoy Two Beginnings by Nico Schroeder. On the program is titled Chic by another New York-based composer, Molly Joyce. This is a sort of really fun, lighthearted, groove-oriented piece, trio for Glockenspiel, interestingly, cabasa, which is a shaker type instrument, and drum set kick drum with a snare drum that is played with a triangle on top of it. And so the idea for that is it creates a little bit of a raspy texture. So this is Chic by Molly Joyce. piece on the program is titled Aria by another Missouri-written composer. Her name is Emma Lunemer. She's from Kansas City, Missouri, originally. And then she went off to study prestigious universities such as Yale and Eastman School of Music for music, and composed a piece for solo organ that she then transcribed for string orchestra. And then a percussionist came along more recently and adapted the piece for marimba quartet. And it's really a beautiful use of the marimba to just hear these, yeah, the warmth of this instrument. So it's often when we play this, I often think of a string orchestra performing it, or even an organ with the just all the dexterity that an organist can play with. So we hope you enjoy Aria. on our program is titled The Surface of the Sky by Blake Tyson. I really love this piece because it uses music to tell a story versus just, music can all be used for so many things, right? Entertainment and bringing people together. But it's such a powerful art form that it can also tell a story, shed light on history, and promote important causes such as social justice. And so I thought I would just read a little bit about the program notes that Blake Tyson gives about this piece, The Surface of the Sky. It was written to commemorate the 60th anniversary of the integration of Little Rock Central High School, and it's dedicated to the 9 students who courageously led the way. In 1957, Little Rock High School became an international symbol of the fight against racial segregation and the struggle for equal rights in the United States. Tyson writes, "The Surface of the Sky does not attempt to depict any specific event of the crisis through music. Instead, I've tried to find a way to honor the bravery and courage of the 9 students through music. They truly risked everything to move us all forward, to stand up to the bullying, the threats, and the hatred. Took incredible strength and character from each of them, and we all owe them our gratitude and our respect." This is The Surface of the Sky. Thank you. then our final piece on the program, titled Apotheosis by Alan Kahn. First and foremost, I'd like to thank these amazing, wonderful students that I get to work with today. They are among the most diligent students I know. They really are. It takes hours and hours of practice and personal score study to look at other people's parts to put on a show like this, where largely there is no conductor, but they're all communicating with each other in chamber music, and that is no easy task. So congratulations to you all. In addition to that, they wear many, many hats. They all come from various majors, some music majors, but also we have majors in chemistry, forensics, criminology, computer science. We even have a member that's joined us from outside of the Lindenwood community. So it's really awesome to see all of them have the same passion for music and come together and create music of this caliber. It's awesome. So thank you all for inspiring me every day. I'd also like to thank the Dean of the College of Arts and Humanities, Kathy Bozovich, and also the Director of the Performing Arts, Jonah Hagen, for their incredible support for the music program here and for percussion specifically. We were very fortunate to receive this brand new Rosewood Marimba this year, and it's just been a privilege to make music with that. It's given us an opportunity to perform music that we wouldn't have been able to do otherwise, such as this piece we just did with three marimbas. So that's really amazing, and we appreciate the support. And lastly, I'd like to thank you all for joining us this evening, spending your evening with us, and I hope you enjoy our last piece, Apotheosis. Thank you.